Hello, I'm still alive. Unfortunately, so is the PragerU channel. Life is hard. There's many new PragerU videos, but we don't have much time. So I will speedrun the debunking of three videos. Not frame by frame though, just countering their general message. Я пожилой дрим. 3, 2, 1, go. Get politics out of sports.
Pro sports has become woke sports. And that's a problem.
This fucking gem is a good example of right-wing double standards. They don't mind the flag waving and the singing of national anthem and the fighter jet flyovers because that's their politics, which is very, very good to have in sports, of course. But as soon as someone who is not a brain-dead hog attempts to use sports to promote different kind of politics, the reactionary snowflakes melt.
A culture that celebrated victors, colorblindness, and patriotism has immersed itself in victimization and left-wing radicalism.
There's no principle to follow here. They're just mad that you can do it too. To which I should say, sorry bitch, it's free speech, the thing that you claim to like so much. So maybe try not being a hypocrite for once, Uyobak. Also, it's weird how they started the video called Get Politics Out of Sports by showing how useful sports are at delivering good political messages.
Owens and Lewis victories punctured Hitler's Aryan superiority myth.
But hey, it's PragerU. They will never make sense. Over-medicated America.
America is sick, and getting sicker by the moment. Is it any wonder, then, that healthcare costs continue to surge out of control?
So, the presenter is a lying piece of shit who, on one hand, says Americans are unhealthy as fuck, and on the other hand says, America has the finest healthcare system in the world, which is the opposite of truth, according to every fucking study ever done. And the reason for this misdirection is to avoid any implication that the system needs to be changed by something like Medicare for All, because that's evil socialism, you know, when you help people. Instead of helping people, PragerU once again wants them to pull themselves up by their bootstraps, because otherwise their donors would have to lose money.
We don't pay enough attention to our own health. The best way not to become a patient is to be healthy.
But the thing is, not every American has graduated medical school and knows what the fuck to do with their health. Many people hesitate going for a checkup where they would be told what they should do in terms of prevention and early treatment because healthcare is expensive and they don't have the spare income. The solution is to make it free at the point of service to have people actually consult with doctors at the onset of sickness, instead of letting shit go untreated for ages and then requiring regular medication and possibly surgeries. Why can I have this in fucking Lithuania, a country no one gives a shit about, but Americans cannot? Also,
most people with type 2 diabetes can come off their insulin simply by changing what they eat. When a disease can be cured by a lifestyle change, medication should be the last resort, not the first.
Diabetes can't be cured with a diet, Marty. It's an incurable disease, you fucking idiot. Our fathers necessary.
For all of recorded history, the need to explain why fathers are necessary would have been regarded as, well, unnecessary.
This video, presented by Penis Drager himself, is riddled with unsubstantiated assertions. The old fuck constantly appeals to common sense and provides zero sources, as per usual. At some point in the video he links crime statistics to fatherlessness, but, как говорится, correlation does not mean causation. Having a father specifically has not been proven to reduce crime rates. What does actually help is having two parents, doesn't matter which gender, both of whom can bring in the money and look after the child. Scientific research consistently shows that same-sex parents are as capable as heterosexual parents, and their children are as psychologically healthy and well-adjusted as those raised by the heteros. So, no, fathers are probably not necessary. Also, let's not forget that it's people like Penis Drager who are responsible for taking away the fathers from poor communities by supporting shit like the drug war. It's hard to have fathers around when the men in your community are constantly being taken away because the lawmakers are afraid of the people who don't look like them. Conservatism is fucking childish. This concludes the speedrun. PragerU hasn't changed. They are as shallow and brainless as ever. Thank you for watching. If you want to support the channel, you know exactly what to do. You're not a fucking child. This has been Daniel, хороший умный парень, бородатый, волосатый, не русский, не коммунист, for Ears and Tail University.